شتان بين النور والظلمات نزلت بذلك محكم الآيات يا غافلا والموت يطلبه أما فكرت فيما تمضي الساعات أقبل على الرحمن واطلب عفوه فعسى المهيمن يغفر الزلات.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء وأشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين. أما بعد, to our brothers in faith, sisters dear in Islam, welcome back to emergency room that we started from the beginning of Ramadan. In this emergency room, we try to make sure that we do not waste our lives or our time because we're in Ramadan. Do you know, my brother in faith and my sister in Islam, that Ramadan has two hearts? How many hearts do you have? You will tell me only one. If somebody says two, you will say, no, you're lying. Why? Because we all have only one. Human being has but one. But Ramadan has two. If you take one, now you talk to me right now. Remove your heart out of your system. Will you even donate your heart? A person may say, well, my kidney. A person may say, well, maybe part of my, oh, I can donate the blood, but no one will give his heart out. Why? Because that's you. So if you take the heart of Ramadan out of Ramadan, no more Ramadan. You may think you're in Ramadan. You may think a person without a heart, his body is there, but he is not a complete human being. So the same thing in Ramadan, when you remove this heart of Ramadan out of Ramadan, no more Ramadan. The first heart is fasting, sawm. The second heart is qira'atul Qur'an, recitation of Qur'an. In the hadith of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, in his Musnad, and also in the book of Imam al-Tabarani, rahimahullah, wa rijal al-Tabarani, rijal al-Sahih, or rijal al-Sihah, or rijal al-Sihah, when they say this, that means the narrators or the transmitters of this hadith are just like the transmitters of the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim. This hadith is also graded by Imam al-Hakim Abu Abdullah as hadith al-Sahih, ووافقه الذهبي رحمه الله وقال الألباني رحمه الله في تعليقه على المشكاه وهو كما قال أي كما قال الذهبي أو كما قال الحاكم وكما وافقه الذهبي. So this hadith is authentic. I wanted to give you, you know, sometimes when you see that people may deny a hadith, you know, you go into takhrij to confirm and comfort them. This hadith is authentic. That's why I did this. Even though usually we do not do it once, you know that the hadith is clearly authentic in Bukhari or Muslim. But this hadith is just like that of Bukhari and Muslim because of what I mentioned. So here, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on the day of Qiyamah, Al-Qur'anu was-siyamu yashfa'ani lil-abd. On the day of Qiyamah, Qur'an and fasting both will intercede for you. Huh? Yes. So when you fast for Allah in Ramadan, do you know a day will come that Ramadan will intercede for you? If you do know, have you taken this into account? If you do not know, well, Inc. is presenting this to you, that your fasting will intercede for you on the day of Qiyamah. What will the fast say? And Quran will intercede for you. What Quran will say on your behalf on the day of Qiyamah? The following is what Prophet taught us. يقول الصوم أو يقول الصيام يا ربي منعته الطعام والشهوة فشفعني فيه. Allahu Akbar. Hadith of Tabarani, as we mentioned in Musnad. Oh Allah, I've deprived him of the following two. His food and his shahwa. He had his wife during the daytime of Ramadan. He ignored her. She had her husband, but she ignored him. No relationship whatsoever, even if shahwa kicks in. He loves eating. It's not like he runs out of food. His fridge is packed with all kinds of food, different kinds. But guess what? He couldn't eat because of you, O Allah. And then Quran will come. O Allah, مَنَعْتُهُ الْنَوْمَ بِاللَّيْلِ مَنَعْتُهُ النَّوْمَ بِاللَّيْلِ فَشَفِعْنِي فِيهِ. I've deprived him of sleep. He did not sleep. I've deprived him of sleeping during the daytime, during the nighttime of Ramadan. And even outside of Ramadan, you see him reciting Quran. And this is a good, you know, a glad tidings to all Hufadh that the best time to memorize or read is at night. Because Quran gives itself to you. So don't sleep like others do. When people are asleep, wake up, because there's time of Quran, like Ibn Mas'ud said. So both will say, oh Allah, allow us to intercede for him because we deprived him of his own, you know, enjoyment in dunya. So we hear for him. So if you know Ramadan will be there for you and your Quran will be there for you, will you fast during the daytime of Ramadan and waste your time? This is an emergency for you. Will you fast and at night you refuse to pray tahajjud and you know Ramadan will come intercede for you and Quran will say, oh Allah, allow me to intercede for him? I don't think you will waste that time, because it's an emergency and you take your emergencies critical. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept that from you. هذا والعلم عند ربي في كتاب. Until I see you tomorrow with the 19th episode of Emergency, keep us in your prayer, because ink always keeps you in authentic environment to take you closer, to link you to Allah. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
شتان بين النور والظلمات نزلت بذلك محكم الآيات يا غافلا والموت يطلبه أما فكرت فيما تمضي الساعات أقبل على الرحمن واطلب عفوه فعسى المهيمن يغفر الزلات.